Set it and forget it. Sounds like a great idea, but is it really?
The School of Podcasting with Dave Jackson.
Hey, I'm Dave Jackson from the schoolofpodcasting.com, where I help you plan, launch, and grow your audience. And today, I want to talk a little bit about SEO. We're not going to get super geeky, but in a podcast movement, Edison Research released a slide that basically showed that where word of mouth used to be the number one way that people heard about podcasts, it's now number two. And number one is Google search, which means we're going to see a lot of people going, I will make you an SEO expert for three easy payments of just, yeah, that's coming. And what I wanted to talk about was there is a feature from most podcast media hosts, and it's called a show player, sometimes called a podcast jukebox, a binge box, whatever you want to call it. It's a thing where you have multiple episodes on one page. And what's great about these is you grab some code, paste it into your website, and you could say show the last 100 episodes. And when you put out another episode, one falls off, one comes on. Done. Set it and forget it. Now, I'm not anti-show player, for the record. Nope, show players are kind of cool. It's a cool tool, but it's not the tool. And why? Because that player that's on your website looks like that information is on your website, and it's not. Behind the scenes, it's actually an iframe. And again, we're not going to get too geeky, but basically it's like, here's your website. Somebody cut a hole out of it and stuck a player in it. But that player is coming from some other website, typically your media host. So what I recommend is you want to have every episode have a blog post. Really, at its core, a podcast is a blog with audio associated with it. It really is. And now what you can do is you can add keywords for that particular episode. You can have links to that episode. And what you're doing is creating content that people are going to want to click to. And what does that do? It boosts your SEO. When somebody comes to your website that doesn't, you know, a new person, they click on play and they sit there and listen to it. Wow, this is pretty good. Well, in Google's eyes, they're like, hey, that's kind of interesting. Every time we send somebody to that website, they stay there for a while. So what does Google do? They bump up your ratings. So I'm just here to say, again, I'm not anti-show player. By all means, have a blog post with your episode and give them the option to have that show player. Oh, and by the way, at the bottom of that show player, please put subscribe buttons. Please, it's all about the subscribers. So have that page if you want to have it. But really, the first line should be, I need a blog post for every episode to boost the Google juice so people can find me. So keep that in mind. I just want you to podcast with informed decisions. Now, if you're ready to take your podcast to the next level, come visit me over at schoolofpodcasting.com, where again, I help you plan, launch, grow, and if you want, monetize your podcast. Thanks for watching.